So this is inside the car. It's fairly clean inside. A few wee niggling faults. First is start from the right, work to the left, I suppose. First problem is the speaker grill is missing. Stand the locking doesn't work, neither with the buttons in the key nor the door. Seems to be slightly erratic. I'm guessing there's some sort of electrical problem. But the air vents have broken out of place. Hopefully it shouldn't be too hard to fix them. This one here is broke, and the passenger side is the same. What's next? The steering wheel controls for the radio at the moment don't seem to be responding, but I think it's something to do with this is sitting out. I'm not sure whether that's the original radio or not, so we'll have to look into that issue. The glove box is broke, to put it nicely. I can open it up, but there's a wee tab there. It doesn't seem to be there on the other side. There's visible marks that someone has busted open a screwdriver in the past, but hopefully, again, that's a panel that it should, or it's one part, it should come out fairly easily. But the seats are tidy. There's no rips or tears in them. The driver's seat here has a height adjustment. Very handy wee system. Up and down. You've a visible crease, but that's just the nature of the fabric, I suppose. It's quite comfortable to sit inside, you know. There's no armrests or anything fancy, but it's a nice comfortable car. Yes, that's the next problem. The electric window for the driver's side. If I put the ignition on, the window's not working. So there's a problem there. I don't know whether it's electrical or the motor's way. More fun. What have we got? There's one more problem. Yes, if we turn the engine on, put that into neutral, turn the engine on, the car starts, of course. A wee bit of a rattle off the belt, but the internal heater, or the blower motor, so to speak, it doesn't, and the speed is stuck on full blast. There's no way to control turning it off or anything. The temperature controls work, and the air directional controls work, but just this one here is stuck on full. So that's another thing to look at. Give the car a quick rev. Turn that off. Engine starts up okay, drives perfectly. Presumably it's a 90 brake horsepower engine. It's not the liveliest engine I've ever, or car I've ever driven, but it's perfectly adequate. I mean, there's no real, you're not buying a racing car, you're just buying a nice comfortable car. So that's that. You've got a map reading light. Does it work? It does work. That works there. And that one works there. You've got a mirror on the driver's side, and you've got a mirror on the passenger side. One of them, just a standard old-fashioned mirror here in the middle. This is an interesting thing with the control of the mirrors here. I thought last night that this was a two-way control. Nearly broke the controller, but it's actually just control for the passenger side. The driver's side actually still gets a manual joystick, so to speak, on the thing. It's quite interesting to see a combination of an electric mirror and a manual mirror in one car, but I suppose it saves costs and there's no real inconvenience using it. What else have we got? Handy wee storage compartment in here, presumably to store CDs. That would have been the fashion back in 2001. I bet there's a storage compartment in the door, big, fairly decent size. There's one on the passenger side as well. So that's the driver's side, a bit of muck on my feet. There's, take a look at the back, get the light round. Open this back door. We have manual windows. Sorry, they're a wee bit squeaky, but that can be sorted out, the work. I don't know what this is. I think that's something related to the child lock, but I was wondered what they do. The Xsara seemed to come with that. The back seats are quite good condition. They're still firm. There's no rips or tears. It's well looked after. The only wee bit of interior damage is, I don't know if you can see it, is that tear on the headline. That's the back. Not much to see in there other than that. The boot. It's a boot. Not much to speak about. Get the lights sorted. So this is the boot here. Quite an interesting, is it? Yeah. Some sort of weird way to, I have no idea how to put the back seats down yet. I haven't really investigated it. Yes, no, 60-40 sort of fold arrangement. And a partial shelf. Spare wheel is kept underneath the car. Easy to steal. The boot carpet has really no interesting features underneath it. Just a boot jack and this piece of plastic are free to roam around the boot. You know, tie them to the side or whatever way is meant to store them. There's a few wee scuffs and scrapes around the back bumper. There we go, and this wee dent here. But it's a 14-year-old car, you can't get any, you know, you expect these things. This is the back. Yep, that's the back. Has a rear wiper, which is handy. This is the back door, it opens. And the back looks the exact same from this side as it does from the other side. And this, open up the passenger side front door, it's all quite tidy. And get a look under the bonnet. Bonnet release on these is down here. That opens there. There's this fuse box beside it. That's the bonnet release. It has a gas strut like the 406 to open the bonnet. This is what we're presented with here. Some must be a fan of the old plastic covers in the engine bay, but it's a fairly standard 2-litre engine that they use. Same as a 406, there's the engine cover. The clips that hold it on have obviously broke, so take that off for the moment and put it on the shelf until such time as we get one of them kits to sort this problem. They broke off, but that's not really an issue. It'll still drive perfectly. That's standard 2-litre HDi. Looks clean enough. I'm not sure. I think it's a Siemens fuel injection here we're dealing with. I'm not sure. I need a ECU there. I'll take a look someday. Need I suppose services car. But the engine's clean enough. Maybe it's had a new MAF sensor or something. There's a wee bit unusual. The wiring here is, looks like somebody's been working on it. There's not too much rust. A wee bit of surface rust there. Not really much to complain about. Underneath that, perfect. Nothing wrong there. So that is the front, the engine bay. I'll hopefully get a servicing video done sometime. It'll be just the same as the 406, I guess. That's the bonnet closed down. What have we got? Just a quick look at the front. There's a slight scuff there, you'd hardly notice it. Yep. I don't have fog lights in the front. I'm not sure if that they're blanking plates for fog lights, but I'll take a look. Don't really see any need to put fog lights on this car. It's not really something I need. It has what looks like a projector unit in the headlight there, and it possibly, I'm not sure if that's the high or low beam, but it's nice to see. I've got wheel trims on the wheels, which are handy. You don't worry when you're driving near a curb if you're going to scuff them. They're quite good nick, the wee wheel trims. So there's that wee kink in the here, this wee dent or whatever it is. No, not really a big problem. There's no rust on the car. These Citroens and Peugeots of this age don't really seem to rust too badly. It's got some sort of, I don't know, an attack on the car has happened at some point, and there's this kink, probably beat round with a hammer, all right. Again, there's no rust. The wheel arches are nice and clean. Haven't been underneath the car on a lift or anything, but it should be all right. I don't see any reason to be worried. There's the fuel cap. It has a locking feature, which is useful. Other than that, there's not really much to say about the car. Hopefully, all them wee issues are not really anything that concerns me. They're all fixable. Shouldn't cost too much to sort out. Hopefully you'll see a few videos of it. As for the rest, at the moment, this is the inside of the shed here. There's the 305. I'm building a rotisserie at the moment to get that spun around. So it's still an ongoing project. I have rust, plenty of rust. There you go, there's a hole in the sill I found after scraping the underseal. I just want to build a rotisserie because I don't like being underneath a car scraping the underseal with a flame. So that'll make it easier, and the rotisserie can be used again hopefully in the future. There's one of the doors. I scraped the underseal off them. It was hiding some surface rust underneath the underseal. I've got a new front valance for the there's another 305 up here. We'll take you to see that. There's the tailgate, by the way. There's the green, the automatic. It's still driving. It'll obviously, there's bits of rust in it, and it'll get the same treatment as the red one when I finish it. But this is the other 305 that my cousin has purchased. It's a van, a 1988, one of the last of the production ones. It was seen a slightly harder life than my S5 estate. The floors are quite rusty. Being a bit of welding, he's done some. The rear wheel arch has got some rust. The tailgate is in quite a bad state. Sills, yep, there's rust, dents. And these, so far, that's the height of the repair, is welding this bit of sill, taking off another 305, but it needs quite a bit of work to sort out. But the rotisserie is going to be used on both 305, so it'll be interesting to see what happens. There's the parts, just quite disorganized looking, but I'm just trying to keep everything together so it's all, everything is labeled and in order. I'll put it back together. There's the new wing I've purchased for it. There's another wing I bought for the car, but it's a series one wing. It's not, it could be cut up, but it'd be a shame just to destroy a good wing like that. It'll do someone maybe restoring a series one 305. There's my original wing there. You can see the rust is damage, you know, caused that. But that's just a wee quick tour of this Xsara and what's happening. I don't normally talk in my videos, but I just thought that I'd give it a bit of a change, you know, try to talk and see what you think. If you like these videos, I'll probably still make the guides as they are, just subtitles. I like doing them like that, but the odd wee talky video like this, I suppose, does no harm. So good afternoon and all that.